Yo guys, what's up? Before we go any further into the story of World War II and invade Poland, it is crucial to take a look first at the country of Poland. Because I showed you guys a map of Europe in 1914 and this country was not even on that map. Now, the reason for that is because the original Kingdom of Poland ceased to exist in 1795. So, more than a century, the country was split into three pieces. The west and north for Germany, the south tip for Austria-Hungary, and the east for the Russian Empire. So, you can imagine the size of that. After the Great War was officially over on the 11th of November 1918, Poland regained all its former territory, including Ukraine and Belarus. But not Lithuania, which had been a part of Poland before 1795. Now, after the Treaty of Versailles was signed in the middle of 1919, the Poles also received Warsaw as a bonus, with loads of oil in Ukraine and a big stain on the nationalist pride of Germany and the Russian Empire. The Poles had enough to survive a few economic storms, but they had to fight for it as well until 1921 because of a few border wars. In 1922, Poland's borders were settled, and in 1923, they were internationally recognized. So on paper, the home of the Poles only exists since 1923. In May 1926, there was a political shock when democracy got terminated by Józef Piłsudski, but there was economic growth until 1939, so really nothing to complain about. 30% of Polish citizens were minorities, such as Jews, Ukrainians, and Belarusians, and they were often discriminated against, even back then, by the Poles. Some of the minorities got fed up with it because there were no privileges for them and they turned against the Poles, so there is a good chance that even back then only 10% of the Poles followed the Jewish religion. And because most of the Jews were pretty successful people, others started targeting them. So not only in Germany were citizens forced to hate everything about the Jewish religion, also, the Polish state was actually too lazy to act and secure the Jewish property. Basically, their country had become too large and too diverse, with too many mixed races. Poles, Germans, Ukrainians, Belarusians, and Jews. A civil war might have been the next step, but Jews lived all over the world, in France, in Holland, Romania, the United States. So they just saw a bad environment in Poland. Poland was basically laughing its ass off for the first time since 1795, feeling free and chilling between the Third Reich and the Soviet Unions for nearly 21 years. Needless to say, Hitler saw Poland as an important Pokemon gym, so to speak, where he could stash all his captured Pokemon from Hungary, Romania, Czechoslovakia, and every Eastern nation that wanted to dump its Jews. He was gonna set up ghettos in every major city of Poland to keep the noise down and to allow the Jews to take their time until early 1941 to move into those friendly ghettos. So, this is where I end my story of Poland 1939, a huge country right next to Germany and the Soviet Union. But the Soviets were not eager to help. They were eager to take it down and reclaim lost property and Ukraine. The first Kingdom of Poland was stripped in 1795. The second Kingdom of Poland was about to be stripped in 1939. See you on the next one, guys. Peace.